there, Ray here, and the latest snapshot, 18W15A, is out, and with it comes a lot of new changes, such as these dolphins and some really crazy behavior. I'll go over all of it today with you. They added dolphins into the game, and they can spawn in any type of ocean that isn't frozen. Here is their spawn egg, it's kind of bluish and white, and there is not a baby variation of the dolphin, there's only adult variation. If we press F3 and B, we can see how big they are, pretty decent size. Dolphins like to play with items that are floating in the water, so here we have a stack of items, and you can see the dolphins are coming over to push it. And normally items would float upwards, but these dolphins can even push items downward so that they never end up coming to the surface. Now if a dolphin is above the water, it will eventually die, so here we have a dolphin, and he's above the water, he starts taking some damage, and then when they do die, they will drop some raw cod. So we just spawned in some dolphins, you see they do enjoy jumping out of the water. Now dolphins have this behavior where they like to try to follow your boat. If you move kind of slowly, they'll kind of come close to you, slowly creep behind you, and they will kind of jump onto you. If you go really fast, they'll try to get out of your way and kind of zip past you, which is pretty cool. Look at these guys go. Now dolphins make this high pitch noise, and they are capable of holding items in their mouth, but for some reason it seems that they can hold the item, but eventually they'll start taking damage from the item, and they can actually die from it. So I don't know if this is supposed to like mimic them like picking up trash in the ocean and dying from it, but it's quite interesting. Dolphins only have 10 health, so they can pretty easily die, as you can see this one here. Dolphins are our social animals, so if you hit one of them, they can come and attack you as a group. So you gotta be kind of careful, but they only do a small amount of damage. Now if you do have dolphins in a small enclosure like this, they can easily jump out. They can even get on top of the land and just kind of wiggle their way off the land and get back into the water. They added a new item in the game called a nautilus shell, and once in a while, rarely, you can find a drown that is holding one, and they will spawn in this way. And killing one of these drowns with it in their hand will allow you to get it as an item. They also added an Heart of the Sea item, and if you put this in the center and you surround it with nautilus shells, you will get a conduit. When placed down as a block, conduit will give a light level of 15 off, so it's capable of like melting these snow layers around me. And it also appears to be a central block with it being surrounded by water. But as you can see, the collision box will not allow you to enter the water. Now, trying to break the conduit in survival don't seem to be really any one tool that makes it easier to break than any other ones. But if you do break it, you can see it's currently putting off the particles as if there is no texture for it. But when you do break it, it will drop the item as you've seen, and it will leave the water behind. On Minecraft Reddit, someone discovered if you put the conduit in the center of a prismarine ring like this and allow it so that there is also water underneath of it, so we remove this block here, the conduit would turn into this weird kind of structure. It's animated and you can't get any close to it, just the same kind of block as before. But as you can see, it's giving off a power effect. So this effect here is called conduit power. And in this configuration, it puts out particles similar to like the enchanting table that all move towards the center of it. Now if you build it up in this configuration, it's even able to kill off hostile mobs that are near in the area. So if we put some hostile mobs over here, such as drowns, they are capable of sometimes taking damage from it. So yeah, you can see this guy in here, he's being attacked. It kind of seems like the structure here, the conduit, is like choosing one of these, and you can see how it's attacking it by sending out these particles. It's like slowly draining away its soul, where the other ones are not being affected. You can kind of see the parameters of the conduit. So I have one placed here, and if I remove this block here, you can see that it will start to pull out these particles from the nearby blocks. You can see what type of blocks it likes. It likes the sea lanterns, as well as the prismarine and prismarine blocks or bricks over here. And the more blocks we add around it, the more it likes it. And this is like very similar to what you see with like a enchanting table. After we get these 16 blocks around it that it likes, it will convert over into this type of the conduit. You can see it's even attacking this elder garden. After I got 48 blocks surrounding the conduit, so it did kill the elder guardian, but he did not drop any loot, so I guess he dropped this fish. But it doesn't kill them as if it was a player kill. Since ocean monuments are made of sea lanterns as well as prismarine and prismarine bricks, it's pretty easy to make a conduit work in these situations by just placing one down like this and you'll get the conduit power. Now the conduit power does some pretty strange things. What it does is it allows you so that you will not lose any of your bubbles from breathing. Here you can see it just completely froze it. I'm also able to see underneath of the water. It kind of gives you like the night vision as in prior snapshots, which it took away from us. And you're supposedly be able to mine blocks a little bit faster, which I can't quite notice. So I went ahead and gave myself conduit power 99. It doesn't currently show on the side, but here we can test out some of the things like mining blocks. You can see, yes, it does help you increase mining blocks. That's pretty cool. Now, you can't pull or push it with a piston, but you can deactivate it just by putting a block beside it. You can see it will stop, and you can also pick block it by holding control and middle click, and you can see that there is different NBT tags. They add a new item in the game called Blue Ice, and this can be made by taking 9 packed ice and crafting it up into a single blue ice. Cup fans showed that this new blue ice has more properties than just the normal ice, in that it can allow items to slide much farther. The difference between normal ice and the new blue ice is that items are able to slide much farther on the new ice. So if we line ourselves and throw an item, and then we line ourselves and throw an item on the normal ice, we can see with the blue ice item is capable of going all the way to here, and with normal ice it's only able to go about here. So it looks like with the new blue ice it's capable of going twice the distance as the old ice. So it went almost 13 meters on the blue ice. It looks like the other properties are very similar to that of packed ice. They also added ice spikes, which generate in frozen ocean. So here's a deep frozen ocean. You see, it looks pretty crazy with the packed ice and the majority of the iceberg being underneath. Some of the icebergs have snow blocks on them, as well as they also go underneath. You see a lot of different variations. Here's one with the new blue ice in it, and it goes inward, and you can see that in the frozen ocean here, there is huge chunks of them, and they make all sorts of types of shapes and figures. It looks really amazing. Inside these large icebergs are full of pockets, and these pockets are full of water. They changed it so that water will only diminish the light level by 1 instead of 3. So here you can see it's 15, now it's 14, 13, 12. This will allow it so that light on the surface can go much farther into the ocean. This will also mean that light sources you place in the bottom of the water will be able to reach farther out. They also changed it so that every ocean variation will have its own color water. Although they seem to have broken the oceans, currently you can see this is where we were testing last time, and it used to be a big coral here as well as a warm ocean. But you can see the water changes here in the swamp biome. So here is a river, and you can see that over here in the swamp, the water is a brownish color, really ugly and murky, kind of what you would expect from a swamp. They also made it so that the water will gradually move from colors of the different types of water. So if we go into our settings, we can see here in our video settings, there is a biome blend. This will allow you to see how abrupt should the biomes switch over. So if you do it off, you can see it abruptly changes from river biome to swamp biome, making it pretty easy to see where the boundaries of different biomes are at. This is also noticeable on grass as well as leaves. Here you can see it's pretty abrupt between these two biomes. If I go ahead and switch this back over, so we got a little bit of blending, you can see it slowly switches. I did find a cold ocean here, and you can see that there is a change in color from the cold ocean over here to a normal ocean. They also changed it so that it's unlikely for a cold ocean to generate next to a warm ocean, and I checked a few places that I've seen this previously in this world, and I couldn't find any of them that repeated it in this snapshot. Now I'm going into swimming mode. It's a lot more smoother. As you can see, my guy gradually switches from standing into swimming. They also added it now so mobs can spawn on top of ice. This may be a bug, but you can see here a polar bear would even like be able to spawn on top of this. You can now swim underneath the one high gaps as you used to be able to, and you can continue on like this, similar to like Elytra mode. There currently seems to be a bug with lava. It currently looks very strange and very dark, even though it is putting off light levels. It still looks like ocean monument generation is a little bit messed up. As you can see, there's an opening right here. They fixed it so that zombies will no longer turn to drowns if they're in water less than waist level. This is something that I used in my trident farm. They now fixed it so that the locate stronghold command now works, and you can even click on it to teleport to that location. They also removed all the vines that were underneath of the jungle biome, something I showed in a previous snapshot. They also fixed it so that you can no longer swim when you're in spectator mode, which was very annoying. Fish in a bucket no longer uses up the fish when you are in a creative, that way we can keep placing them. Plus a ton of other different bugs that they fixed in a snapshot. I'll put the whole link down in the description, which goes to the Minecraft Reddit. Dolphins and crazy conduit power. So there you guys have it for the latest 1.13 snapshot. So if you found this interesting, show me a like and share it with others. And if you'd like to see more snapshot reviews like this, subscribe and hit the bell button. And if there's anything I forgot in the snapshot, tell me down in the comments. Bye bye.